actually buzzing the answers. Now, a multigravida, this is a common sense question. Did you do your housemanship and followed the instructions of general medicine, M2 unit or M3 unit kind of a question this is? 26 weeks presenting with hemoglobin of 6. What is the ideal management? How much it is? Question was wrongly typed. Okay, 20 weeks. Bahut badhiya hai. So what is your answer? Parenteral iron therapy. What is mouth doing? Mouth of the patient, gut of the patient are intact. No, why you wanted to bypass them and then give parenteral? Huh? Because it is severe? What is your answer? Parenteral you said, no, that's what I am trying to debate on. Ah, very good. Why not packet cell transfusion? While going to honeymoon, you can go by train. End of the honeymoon, you prefer coming by flight. Why? Because you reach an intolerable level by the end of the honeymoon. And you feel time is very short, let me go back to my hospital. Enough of honeymoon. So, 34-35 weeks may anemia detected, last 1 month of the gestation may, that time you need to go by aeroplane. Then packet cell transfusion is indicated. Whereas if you give either oral or parenteral therapy, it takes about 5 to 6 weeks for the iron levels to improve. That you can gain the time because it is still 20th week of pregnancy. So oral iron therapy is preferable. If it is intolerable, then that is an indication for the parenteral therapy. The mere severity doesn't dictate you to go for parenteral. Huh? 6 is too low, but oral and parenteral will same time will land you. Instead of going by bus, you are going by train. Huh? Both of them, parenteral and oral, will take 5 to 6 weeks. Instead of gut, you are bypassing the gut by giving iron injections. Right? Huh? From the gut it become absorbed. Time taken is from gut directly into blood only, no? Here you are giving directly into blood. Huh? No. That is a misconception. There's a difference between packet cell transfusion which is aeroplane versus oral iron therapy which is like going by train, which is more or less same like going by bus. Which is the parenteral therapy if you can't tolerate the vibration of the train? So, if you give iron orally, if the woman can't be able to tolerate the iron. So, our online students, Ved etc. are also proposing not the packet cells but oral iron therapy, which is the standard practice. But this question is... Medicine-oriented obstetrics is always challenging. Obstetrics purely is easy subject. Huh? So, now, alright. We are expected to give oral iron therapy. 100%. I can vouch my MD, general medicine degree from Nizam's for that. So, see. How rapidly is the emergency? Last 1 month may, it is an emergency. You don't have time to bargain. There it is parenteral iron therapy. There it is the packet cell transfusion. Transfusion doctor is the one which you have to avoid in all possibility. Any day, it is not an easy thing like eating chocolate or drinking cool drink. Right? Now, cavalier uterus is a complication of cheapest question in the planet. It is the severe most form of the concealed accidental hemorrhage. Now, orthotic conjugate is distance from where to where? Orthotic, diagonal, this you should not do mistake. So what is your answer? Option 4, the inner surface of the pubis to the prominent bony projection. Prominent bony projection on the inner surface of the pubis to the sacral promontory. Answer D is the correct answer. Now, this is another tricky question. Least mortality is for which disease? What is your answer? Patent ductus arteriosus. Aortic heart disease is easily manageable. Then, between stenotic and regurgitant lesions, which will improve with pregnancy, which will worsen with pregnancy. All regurgitant valvular heart diseases improve with the pregnancy. Stenotic valvular heart diseases will worsen because in pregnancy there is an increased plasma volume which will worsen the stenotic heart disease. So aortic stenosis becomes worsened. So correct answer is D. This is a number game. Itna padne ke baad kitna percentage mein uterus rupture ho jayega bole to purely luck. That's the reason for Rahu, Ketu, everyone, you have to do Japam and go to the exam hall. Then you will do it correctly. You ask an astrologer. Otherwise, if you don't get seat, start giving astrology. That is the best way of earning money. Yeah. Question number 32. Who will give the correct answer? Swati says C. Initially she said D. Then changed the answer. Oh, sorry. That was for the 31st question. Okay, what is your answer? Raj, what is he saying? Raj is saying what? Question number 32. What is your answer, doctor? Meanwhile, before our online students pick up. 0.2 to 1.5 is looking beautiful range, which we can, somewhere answer will be lying down. That's our guess, right? Very good. Anu is also saying C, which is correct. To be more precise, 0.3% women attempting VBAC are the ones who experience the rupture of the scar. That's the reason, but if you do continuous monitoring, then that incidence can be reduced to in fact 0.03%. So that's the reason the correct answer will be option number C. This is only 25% people might have shot it correctly. Those who are good in their guesswork. Not even guesswork, lucky in their number work. That's all. Malaria in pregnancy. No luck here, sir. Precise fact. What is your answer? Primaquine. Anybody by chance thought it as mefloquine? Oh. So, drugs in pregnancy, doctor. Malaria, TB, antiretrovirals. You must be very sure. So, primaquine. Tetracycline, doxycycline, halofantrin, primaquine, tafenoquine, they are all contraindicated in the pregnancy is what need to be remembered. Physiological changes in pregnancy is a favorite topic of the examiner. So finally, you don't need more than 625 topics, doctor, I can bet it. Syllabus of the entrance is defined. To read about those 625 topics thoroughly itself is a humongous effort. There is no need of wasting time. You need to be very sure. When you open the book in biochemistry, first thing is read vitamins, read citric acid cycle, read fatty acid beta oxidation, ultimately not more than 20 topics. If you read more than that list of 625 which I gave you, it will be indigestion. So question number 34, what is your answer? Excellent. Very good. I know a lot of you might have answered it correctly. That's good. So, there is a decrease in the concentration of the serum creatinine which falls on average by about 0.4 milligram per deciliter. That's the reason a creatinine 1 is normal in normal people. In pregnant women, it means to say impaired renal function. Even creatinine 1. This is cheapest question. Which is dangerous placenta previa, doctor? Question number 35. Yeah. Type 2 posterior. No big deal. Then, Brenner's tumor of the ovary is an epithelial tumor. No big deal. Easiest question in the planet. Acidity of the vagina is because of Dodeline's bacillus. Very easy question. Everybody will answer. HCG is increased with all. Suddenly anybody got an idea? Partial and complete. Both of them are there. One of them only, not both of them. No. So what is your answer? It is not in endodermal sinus tumor where you have alpha fetoprotein, which is an important tumor marker. Then, deep dyspareunia is typically seen with all except, what was your actual answer? Oh, I thought that will be the most common wrong answer. Prolapsed ovaries in the pouch of the Douglas. Why you thought like that as answer? I know. Suddenly somewhere, somewhere you remembered. Parietal pleura is pain sensitive. Visceral pleura is not pain sensitive. Ovaries are hanging into the visceral pleura. Peritoneum. Maybe it is not painful. No, sir. Very painful condition. Lot of students answered B. So this is another 50-50 kind. If you are not good in elimination tactics. Question number 39. Fahima proposes D altogether. Endometriosis, classical of dyspareunia. Of course, Fahima still has another 6 months. She recently joined us. Dr. Ved and Jabalpur are saying it as senile atrophy of vagina, which is the correct answer. Very good. This is another chance. I took half an hour to conclude the answer of this question. Searched every part of the entire Pan-America, Pan-Asian online network for the correct answer. What is your answer? You are lucky, guys. 1 minute you took a decision, answered, came out of exam hall. But I took half an hour. Ultimately, I thought, this is a waste life. Let me at least have dinner. And then once more started the hunting game. So tell me, doctor, what is your answer? Swati proposes middle rectal. What was your answer? Inferior vesicle was your answer. Any other answer? So there is a fight between only these two. Alright. Why inferior vesicle? Because inferior vesicle is the counterpart in the male. Fundamentally, if you look at the blood supply of the vagina, there is a vaginal artery which is the branch of the uterine artery. And it can also arise from the internal iliac artery. And the two vaginal arteries will anastomose with the cervical branch of the uterine artery. The internal pudendal and the vaginal branches of the middle rectal also will supply the vagina. So these arteries form the anterior and posterior azygous arteries to supply. So who is all involved? Middle rectal is involved, internal pudendal is involved, and also the vaginal branch of the uterine artery is involved. So who is not involved? Inferior vesicle is involved. Is not involved. So that way it became the answer.